I come before you with contrite heart. Humbly I surrender all that I am. I want to learn from you. Please draw me close to you. Help me share your love and grace in all I do. Lord, I come before you with contrite heart. Humbly I surrender all that I am. I want to learn from you. Please draw me close to you. Help me share your love and grace in all I do. Lord, transform me, change my heart completely to be more like you. Oh Lord, renew me, heal my mind and broken heart today. I want to be and to do what you commanded, and be filled Spirit every day. I want to serve you wherever you may lead me. I want to serve you till the very end. Oh Lord, transform me, change my heart completely to be more like you. Shine a light to a darkened world, and always live your truth in every way. May your love for me be seen by everyone, and lead others to trust and love you more.
And welcome to another episode of Youth Life. We welcome both our online viewers and our live studio audience here with us tonight. I know this week was a back-to-school week for many persons, teachers, and students, and I know that we are all so happy to be in the presence of the Lord tonight. With me tonight, I have four lovely persons here with me. They will introduce themselves to you.
Good night, everybody. I'm Jamal Belfon from the Paradise Seventh-day Adventist Church, and I attend the T.A. Marischal Community College.
Good night, everyone. I'm Lissady Williams.
Good evening, everybody. My name is Maxine Noel.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Mikita Williams.
And I am Towino Williams, your host for tonight. Right before we get into our praise and worship segment, we'd like to say welcome to some of our online viewers. And we see that we have Sister Rosalyn Jeffers McCoy. She says, happy Sabbath to all. We say happy Sabbath to you.
Happy Sabbath to you.
We have Francisca Purpy. We have Dwight McLeish. We have Shadina Scott and Vicky Cato.
All right, we say welcome and happy Sabbath again to all our online viewers. Right before we go to our praise and worship session, we don't want to be selfish. We want to share the love of Jesus to everyone. So please like and share our page, Mission Live Grenada. And so our first song tonight will be Hymn 381. 381.
Four, wake the song of joy and gladness. 3-4.
Every thought of sadness.
Kim 4:34-434. Final hymn 381. We sang that already. Okay, we'll take hymn 15:15. So good when you can just praise and worship God. Tonight we'll be looking at Who Has My Compass. Tonight our discussion will be on Who Has My Compass. Now, when hearing that topic, you might be thinking, who is guiding me? So we want to figure out tonight who is guiding in our lives. And so the question tonight is there a difference between self-control and self-denial? Is there a difference between self-control and self-denial?
Well, yes, there is a difference, right? Self-denial is like when you don't look at yourself first, you don't put yourself first, right? You put aside your personal desires and you care for others. And then self-control is having control over yourself, emotions, your feelings, and you know, your actions.
Okay.
I will look at it in the sense of, I'm going to look at it as Jesus saying. So for self-denial, Jesus would be saying, let go of self. And for self-control, Jesus would be saying, follow me.
Okay, thank you. Now we're looking at this discussion on the food. Now, what kinds of problems do people have exercising self-control with food? What kinds of problems do people have with exercising self-control of food? or with food?
Well, there can be different areas you can look at. We can look at it from the facts with the Bible. Okay, so God told us there are certain foods that we should eat and there are certain foods we should not eat. So self-control, some of us already knew some of the foods that we shouldn't eat, like pork. Okay, so some of us used to eat pork before and we know how good it tastes. Self-control will be when you're not supposed to eat pork now, even though you think that it tastes good, is a principle that God says no, so you have to stop. That's from one side.
And I also think when it comes to the question that is asked, persons not knowing the difference between hunger and appetite, not knowing what's the difference between following your stomach or following your mind. So it could be within these both disciplines.
Okay, and for our online viewers, we want you to be active with us. We want you to tell us your answers as we ask the questions. Feel free, drop in a comment. Let us know what your thoughts are on these questions. So we're moving on. What kinds of messages do we get from society and the media about food? What kind of messages do we get from society and the media from food?
Well, as you see, most of the advertisements these days pertaining to food, they'll tell you, spend all your money, well, not in the exact sense, but you see, buy all you want or eat as much as you want, it's your choice. So to me, what the media and society is teaching us just to make as much money as they can is to not have self-control pertaining to food.
Okay.
Also, sometimes you see that the advertisements, they show you the unhealthy food at a cheaper cost. So they encourage you. Sometimes you may see KFC put a special, you know, you get whatever for that amount. So you see the media promotes the unhealthy food at a cheaper cost, and the healthier food, you see that it's much more expensive.
Okay. I'm seeing Sister Vernice Bramble saying happy Sabbath from the Emerald Isle, Montserrat. So we have Montserrat in the house. We say happy Sabbath to you.
Happy Sabbath.
Also, we have Sister Shoma Francis. This is one of our Shantimel people out there. We say happy Sabbath to you, sister. And so we move on to our third question. What does God's word have to say about it? What does God's word have to say about it?
Well, I think the Bible have a lot of things in relation to having self-control when in regards to food. The Bible says, whatever we do, whether eat or drink, we should do it to glorify God. There's a text that also says that we should be temperate in all things. So even though food is a good thing, we need to be temperate when it comes to food. We need to be temperate or have self-control when it comes to food as well.
And 1 Corinthians 6:19-20 tells us that our bodies are the temple of God. So that shows us that we are important to God and that we should take proper care of our bodies.
Okay, and we've seen Sister Nikisha Alexander says Leviticus 11 tells us. Okay, how does a lack of self-control in this area affect our lives?
Well, having a lack of self-control when pertaining to food, you can eat too much, and according to what you eat, you can get obesity or maybe hypertension or high blood pressure and different sicknesses come with it.
Okay.
Also, you could be broke because you don't have no self-control. You have, you cook your food home, but you go out and you still want the food outside, and you spend your money instead of eating your nice fig and salt fish home, and you go and you buy your KFC outside because you can't, So you end up broke.
Yes. And so, what are some tips to help people be more self-controlled in this area? So tell us, what are some tips to help people be more self-controlled in this area?
Well, one of the things, first of all, you should always call on God for help.
Yes.
In any situation like that. But the Bible says faith without works it's basically nothing. So even you can ask God to help you in this situation, but then you need to now take action. So I would say we have persons who can help people who have problem with self-control when it comes to food. If you need to see a nutritionist, or if there is a family member who can assist you, you should really seek someone else who can help you, who would be stronger in that area.
Okay.
Well, one thing you can do well, the Bible speaks about temperance, right? So we must be temperate in whatever we do. What is temperance? Temperance is being moderate in what is good and abstaining from what is bad. So once we be temperate, and as was said before, we trust in God and we have faith, then we will be able to have self-control over food.
Okay, so let's take some comments from our online viewers. We see we have Rondell Wilson, and it says, self-control encompasses self-denial, but it is broader. Self-denial is the idea of denying yourself certain things and abstaining, not putting yourself first. Self-control means controlling your actions overall, which can mean denying or being moderate. And we do agree with what she's saying. We also see we have Tricia Jones Williams.
And she says, the only true guidance on food are the ones given by God. Every other guideline is to make money. That's so true.
All right. Okay, so just to recap, tonight we'll be discussing who has my compass. Who has my compass? And we say that Sister Shoma Francis says to be temperate in everything. To be temperate in everything. I'm seeing King Julian. Brother George, good night. Happy Sabbath to you. He says, improper diets or lack of nutrients can also lead to poor eating habits. For example, lack of magnesium causes sugar craving.
True.
Okay, so at this, and we see Brother Ronzel Garraway, one of our fellow Yushans.
Happy Sabbath.
Happy Sabbath, Brother Ronzel. Happy to see you tonight, logged on. He says, happy Sabbath to you guys. Nice seeing you guys. It's an important topic.
Definitely.
Okay, at this time, we will have special music.
Certain circumstances, things I could not understand. And many times in trials, weakness blessed my vision, and my frustration gets so out of hand.
But it's there, I am reminded, I've never been forsaken. Never had to stand one test alone. Cause when I looked at all the victories and the spirit rises up in me, it is through the fire my weakness is made strong. Oh,
he never promised that the cross would not get heavy. And the hill will not be hard to climb. He never offered a victory without finding, but he said help will always come in time. Just remember where you're standing in the valley of decision, and the adversary says, give in, just hold on. Our Lord will show up and he will take you through the fire again.
I know with myself that I will surely perish. Oh, if I trust the mighty hand of God, he'll
shield the flame. That the cross will not get heavy.
and the hill will not be hard to climb. He never offered a victory without fighting, but he said help will always come in time. Just remember when you're standing in the valley of decision,
and the adversary says, amen.
Just hold on, our Lord will show up.
Yes, he will.
And he will take you through the fire again.
So just hold on,
our Lord will show up.
Back to Youth Life Unplugged. That was such wonderful singing. We just want to welcome some persons again. I want to welcome some persons live here tonight. And I'm seeing Sister Tracy Francois. We welcome her in the house tonight. I'm seeing Elder Williams and Sister Princess in the house. Mommy and Daddy, we welcome you. I'm seeing Sister Gabby Fleming. We welcome you in the house tonight. I'm seeing Brother Clayman. We're also happy to have them here tonight. Okay, now I'm seeing that three of you are wearing kente cloths. So I'm assuming that you three went to the same university. Okay? So this should be quite interesting. It says, why does it take self-control to get an education? Why does it take self-control to get an education? So we have three graduates from the University of the Southern Caribbean, and we have this young man here still in TAMCC. So share with us, online viewers, tell us, why does it take self-control to get an education?
Well, it's very essential when it comes to academia in regards to self-control. For instance, when I was in university, there were so many activities that you could have participated in. And when I just started, I wanted to participate in all those activities. Then I realized that if I have no self-control, I will get myself in trouble. So when it comes to self-control in acquiring your education, it is very important and essential, because if you don't have it, you would have a tendency to your grades would drop and so on. You would not be successful in regards to education. I think it's a key component when it comes to education.
Yes, right before you, Sister Williams, we just want to acknowledge the online viewer. She was saying something with our previous discussion. She says, okay, Rhonda Wilson. She says, a strategy you can use to help combat overeating is to plan your meals beforehand. When you're eating randomly, you're much more prone to overeating. Also, it's easier to get hungry when you're idle, so keeping yourself occupied also helps, and that's so true. So moving back to the question, why does it take self-control to get an education?
Well, as Brother Maxine was saying, sometimes you want to get yourself into so many activities, but I would like to look at the other side. Sometimes we only look at education as, you know, just a notebook and pen. But to me, education is so much more than that. So I think it's striking the right balance. You should not study so much that you are only a book person and you do not know what is going on in your everyday life. You cannot socialize properly. All that is a part of education. So I think, what do you think, Brother Max? There should be a balance there as relates to, you should be able to study, but yet still be involved. To me, that would be an overall.
Well, that's true. Yeah. You must have the balance, and yes. That's correct.
And I'm seeing Sister Serena English saying, because you want to be successful in everything.
I was just about to say the same thing. Self-control with education helps you to be successful because, well, I'm going to use myself. So sometimes when I had labs in the morning, right, and in the night before let's say there's an activity in school you might want to go to, or there is something you want to look at, some show or movie or some book you want to read, but you're supposed to get yourself ready for early in the morning. And if you know that doing that activity would make you tired, that you're not able to get yourself ready afterwards, you need to have the discipline to tell yourself, go to the book, get your stuff ready so that when you enter the lab in the morning, you're confident and you can do the work that is required for you to do. So I'll say self-control helps a lot with that.
Yes.
Some other points which were shared by the graduates, right? I learned that, and some I learned the hard way, right? Upon joining college, right, my first year, we were asked that, well, one of the requirements to graduate is to participate in curricular activities. So upon signing up for some of the activities, I saw so much that I liked. I almost signed up for all, but not all, not yet. And for most of them that I signed up for, I was not able to attend one meeting. So for only two, I've been active in. Only two, yes.
All right, so I'm still throwing out a question. Students, school start back this week. We want to hear from you online viewers. Tell us, why does it take self-control to get an education? Tell us. What are some of the messages we get from others that might keep us from exercising self-control in this area? What are some of the messages we get from others that might keep us from exercising self-control in this area?
Well, I think my dear sister had made reference to it earlier. Some friends would tell you, but you're studying too much a book, you need to take a break, come outside and play. So they would try to get you away from the book, but as she said, you have to have strike a balance between play and book, you know?
And also, not everything goes for everyone. I remember at school, there was this student, right? When she was with us, she seemed to be a party goer. So she only partied and she seemed like she didn't read her books or anything like that. But little did some of my friends know that after the party, she had the energy to stay up, read her books, do her assignments, and go to class. And some of them who followed her, they did not have that energy. So, you know, they were in trouble at the end of the day. So sometimes you don't always do as others do. You have to find out what is good for you and work with what your body can work with.
Okay, mm-hmm. So let's hear from the online viewers. I'm saying Nikisha Alexander, area of study. Remember doing psychology and philosophy, and if I didn't know Christ and the Word of God, it could have led me astray. I had to be careful which areas I could do projects on because a lot of it contradicts the Word of God.
True. Yeah, sometimes you have to be strong, especially when you do different religions and stuff. Sometimes you get carried away with the different philosophies and you have to be grounded in what you actually believe in so that you will not be carried away.
Also, we have Pastor Gulliman saying, self-control goes hand in hand with time management and prioritizing.
Amen. Why is it so important to be self-controlled about our education? Why is it so important to be self-controlled about our education?
Well, coming from the Caribbean and going to study in another place, let's say especially those who study probably in Africa, America, the far countries, and you know it takes a lot of money to do so. You don't want to waste your money because monies are hard to come by. You don't want to waste your parents' money. So basically, you do not want your monies to go down the drain. So it's important to, you know, exercise self-control with your education.
Okay, so we have Kira Nicholas saying, keeping focus and prioritizing. Okay. Tell us, how can the Bible help us in this area? How can the Bible help us in this area?
Well, the Bible says in Proverbs that like a city whose walls are broken through is a person who lacks self-control. So it's very critical for the individual who want to acquire education, that they be self-disciplined or have self-control in order to be successful.
Ecclesiastes 3:4 tells us about there's a time to weep. There is a, just paraphrase,
paraphrasing, there's a time to weep, there's a time to laugh. And so if we have to put that in our own context, there's a time to go to socials, there are times to study, there are times to go down the road with your friends, there are times to go to meetings. So you all have to put everything in moderation.
Okay, so remember, online viewers, we don't want to keep all the information to ourselves. We want the world to know. So we want you to like and to share the page. We want to see people from all over the world locked down here with us tonight. At this time, we'll pause for a special music. Gospel music. I want to take this time to shout out some of my Yushan friends that logged on. Sister Shanice Bowman, happy Sabbath, and welcome to Youth Live Unplugged. She's all the way in St. Vincent. Sister Crystal Shallow, Zenica Peters, welcome to Youth Live Unplugged. Continue watching as the discussion goes by.
We also have Giona Bob. That's one of my friends. We have Charles Hamlet. We have Sorana English, and one of her comments were, when you have to get your education, you cannot follow someone else. You have to be by yourself, be your only daughter, and you will get there. We also have Trisha Jones Williams, and her comment was, yes, there is a time and place for everything. Know what you want and work towards it.
And we see we have Sherman Bihari. keep focused on God's word and don't have bad company. Don't have bad company. We have Trisha Williams back saying, "Oh my, I love that song. It reminds me that I'm nothing without God."
Amen.
And I'm seeing one of my Yushan friends again, Shariel. Happy Sabbath, Sister Kami. Yes. Happy Sabbath.
Yes, Sister Kami, Sister Shariel, happy Sabbath. Good to see you guys. I see Sister Curlin. Happy Sabbath to you. Sister Candice Castello, happy Sabbath to you as well. Brother King Julian, we saw you earlier, and happy Sabbath to you as well.
All right. So tell us, and online viewers, we want to hear from you too. Tell us one of the bad experiences you were faced with at school when it came to self-control. Tell us, online viewers, Sister Shanice, Sister Shariel, Sister Kami, Pastor Guleman, we want to hear from you. Tell us one of the bad experiences you were faced with about self-control in school.
I remember there was a time when I just went to Trinidad because I started USC at Guyana. So when I went over to the main campus, because you had to pay your fees and so on, I started to do around 6 or 7 jobs per day on the campus during the week because I really wanted to acquire funds to pay off tuition and to pay CAF and so on. And I can remember doing that throughout a couple of months. There was one particular time when I really got sick. Now, when I went over to Trinidad, I never used to eat chicken, right? So when I went over there, I was strictly a fish and so on. But when I got over there and during that period of time when I was doing those several jobs, I got really sick. And the only option, I remember my friend saying, listen, you need to get some protein, and the fastest protein you could get is KFC. So I remember that time going back on the chicken part and so on. But this was one of the time I was not being self-controlled, even though it was something that I was trying to do to get the funds to pay for school. But that was one of the baddest experiences that I had when I was in Trinidad.
Okay. And you see, that's where temperance come back. Be moderate in whatever is good.
I think for me, probably it was, there are many times, but as a resident assistant on dorm, you know, sometimes you get to work hours that you don't really want to work, and sometimes it's, you know, it can be a disadvantage. And as all my friends know, I like cricket. So when the team, school cricket team would be playing, sometimes when I'm working, I'm unable to go. But I remember this particular time, I told myself, you know what, forget work. I'm going to my cricket match. And so I went to the cricket match, and then when I came back, I was in real big problems, you know. But thank God for his forgiveness and his mercy. So, yeah, that's my experience.
Well, mine is something like hers. I like to read a lot of books. I'm not referring to the books, beside the books you have to read for your classes, I'm not referring to those. I like to read generally, and I think it happened a number of times. I would be reading and so captivated in the book. I know that I have to study for a particular quiz or other, and I will be reading so much and cannot stop myself from reading that the next day when I get up, suddenly I'm so tired. And I go to the class, and I know I have the quiz, and I just praying, oh, gosh, please, don't make us have this quiz today because I'm not prepared. And, well, I'm not taking it for granted, no, because God really helped me out there because I remember a number of times the teachers canceled the quizzes, so I'm very grateful, but that is a way you should not go.
Okay, so let's hear from our online viewers. We have Franklin Swin. Says, good night, all. Since the book of nature and the book of Revelation bear the impress of the same mastermind, they cannot but speak in harmony. By different methods and in different languages, they witness to the same great truths. Science is ever discovering new wonders, but she brings from her research nothing that, rightly understood, conflicts with divine revelation. The book of nature and written word shed light upon each other. They make us acquainted with God by teaching us same of the laws through which he works. Education, page 128.
Well said.
Okay, we see we have Brother Ronzel Garaway.
And he said, self-control is important in your academic life. Whatever you put in, that's what you will receive. You have to discipline yourself to achieve success in your educational life, and which is very true. And look at another friend of mine, Pastor Paul Roach, happy saying, happy Sabbath, guys. Happy Sabbath to you. I hope everything is okay with you.
I'm seeing Patrick Krieger. That's one of my friends from Suriname. Good evening. Happy Sabbath to you. So we have Suriname in the house. We say happy Sabbath to you.
We have a comment by Sarana English. She said, when I was going to school, I couldn't control myself because all the children picked on me.
We see Shariel. Oh, yes, Sister Shariel, I'm putting you on the spot. So come and tell us of one of the experiences. Francis Hamlet, happy Sabbath to you all. Happy Sabbath to you. And we see we have a comment by Nikisha. Being mocked about not eating the oil with pork just for being an SDA.
Yeah, that's true. True, and true. That's very tough. Eh? Normally, yeah. When I, you know, when I see I have oil long and I bring the along to school, they ask with the pork or, you know, with the salt meat, only salt fish, and I learned the nice with only salt fish or, you know, the other stuff. They want to see the pork and dice or make the island nice.
Yes. And so we're going to take another comment before moving on again. Paul Roach, Pastor Roach, I remember first year on campus in Trinidad, USC. I wanted to be involved in everything. I'm so doing, I pay less attention to my studies and ended up with bad grades for that semester. Self-control helps one to be focused on what God has assigned that person to do.
Amen.
And that's true.
And that's a true experience that he's given there, because I could attest to that.
And we have Sister Shariel. She's saying, similar to brother there, being a female and fashion standards of the campus, sometimes you get caught up in the trends. That being said, Tunapuna sister, Tunapuna was my weakness. Sometimes rather than sitting and writing up my labs or studying my book, I'm tipsing to Tunapuna and shopping to shop. Self-control and self-discipline are definitely traits I have to strengthen. So true, Sister Shariel. Thank you for sharing.
All right, and we see Elsa Sinclair says, good night, saints of God. And we say, good night to you. Okay, is it really necessary to have self-control over what kinds of entertainment we choose? Tell us, online viewers, we want to hear from you again. I love the discussion. Tell us, is it really necessary to have self-control over what kinds of entertainment we choose?
Well, to me, I find we reach the best spot right now, right? Entertainment, if you don't have self-control on what you're entertaining yourself with, sometimes you might end up on the wrong site or watching the wrong things. Or yes, once you don't have self-control, you might end up entertaining yourself on things that is ungodly or things that is wrong.
Okay.
Yeah, sometimes I think with the entertainment, probably as a student sometimes, children at secondary school, instead of doing your chores or assignments that are assigned for you, you find yourself caught up on your laptop or watching TV or on your phone for the entire evening. And the next day, when the teacher asks you for your homework, you have no homework. So I think sometimes you can get caught up in the entertainment as well.
And we see we have a comment from Sister Shanice Bowman. She's saying, being a very jovial, social individual, I wanted to be involved in all the extracurricular activities on my campus. However, it came to a point where I was being involved in more social activities than I could have handled. There and then came the issue of balancing school and my social life. Also, you need to be aware of your friends and the company you keep. They can also help you in keeping the balance.
True.
Yeah,
well
true.
Said.
Yeah.
Very true. Very true. Okay, so how does the entertainment we choose affect us? How does the entertainment we choose affect us?
Well, I think entertainment, when it comes to entertainment, all entertainments, whether it is good or bad, affects the mind. And the Bible says that we must be transformed by the renewing of the mind. So based on what you entertain yourself with could affect you mentally. That's why it's very important that we be self-controlled in those regards when it comes to entertainment.
And also what you feast upon, what you, as brother said, what you feast upon, what you constantly feed yourself with, that is what you would produce. So if you constantly feed yourself with negative words, curse words, sometimes you listen to the rap songs with all the cursing and negative suicidal songs, anything that is negative, you'll have a negative spirit. If you live to listen to things that are uplifting and positive, you tend to be pleasant and always tend to have a word of encouragement to share with someone. So yeah.
Also, if entertainment takes up a heavy portion of your day, then you would hardly have time for God, so your spiritual life would also decrease. And you can also think about those around you. Let's say you like gaming, and you're so caught up in gaming the whole day. What about those around you? If you have a spouse or if you have parents, what about your chores in the house or some of the things you're supposed to do around you are also affecting those around you?
Yes. And tell us, what does the Bible have to say about our choice of entertainment? What does the Bible have to say about our choice of entertainment? We see here Sister Shannon saying, yes, I agree, Sister Kita, 100. Okay, so what does the Bible have to tell us about our choice of entertainment? Tell us, online viewers, we want to hear from you. We want to have a nice discussion with you tonight. Tell us, what does the Bible have to say about our choice of entertainment?
Well, I think we can apply the text that says, by beholding we become changed. Whatever we endorse ourselves in regards to entertainment, it would have an impact on our mental disposition. It will affect us whether it may be good or bad. That's why it's very critical that we as young people seek to behold Christ daily and consistently so that we can be transformed like him. So we must really be a people that is beholding good things rather than negative things.
Yes. We see a comment from Tricia Jones, from Patrick Kager. He says, entertainment is a dangerous weapon in the hand of the adversary. Adventist Home, the chapter on the gateways of the soul, talks about that. We see Tricia Williams saying, yes, yes, yes. This one is of great importance, especially in today's society. Entertainment greatly affects people, especially students, once it is not controlled properly. In every form of entertainment, guidance and self-control is needed.
And that's true. That's true. Well said.
And just to add with what the sister just said, you know, guidance is really needed. Sometimes I see parents leave entertainment as a form of babysitting for their kids. You know, the child is crying, so they just give the child the tablet, and that's it. They look at movies. You know, children these days, from 2 years, they can go on YouTube and do whatever they like. So I think control and guidance is needed by the parents to direct them in whatever way possible.
Let's hear from the online viewers. Let's see what they're saying. This is the Shariel. I can speak to the music aspect. You ever notice how 10 minutes in a minibus plants the dancehall songs on your mind? Imagine actually sitting and listening to them willfully. Those things influence you sometimes without you even trying. That's why we must be very careful about what we put in our minds. That's so true. Pastor Guleman was saying, watch your thoughts. They become words. Watch your words. They become actions. Watch your actions, they become habits. Watch your habits, they become character. Watch your character, for it becomes your destiny. Very true, Pastor Guleman.
And Sister Roach commented to us, sharing the Bible text, Romans chapter 12, verse 2, and it reads, and be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God.
Okay, and we see another comment. Spice Lady, Brave Boy.
What are you guys' area of study that might help us understand how you exercise self-control? So I guess that's for us. It is asked, what are your areas of study that might help everyone understand how to exercise self-control.
Okay, and we see we have Shariel again. I'm so happy that, you know, my Yushans, they're here tonight. We need to spread the love of Jesus to everyone. I want to see different countries locked down here with us tonight so that we can share the love of Jesus. We have Sarana English again. When going to school, you have to be your own leader. If you do not be your own leader, no one will be for you, and you will fall short and say you didn't know tomorrow. That's so true. And Trisha Williams saying, yes, the music interferes with the brain very quickly. And I think we can testify to that. You know, sometimes you go in, it might just be a 5 minutes, and all the boom, boom, boom on the bus, you know, just get into your head. And one time you learn a song just like that. We see we have Cassandra. Even programs in the church that seek to entertain such a certain trend that lead persons to think that church is boring when there is no entertainment.
One of the things that can cause persons to see that, right? What we occupy ourselves with at home, right? If we don't listen to the gospel, or we don't, you know, study our quarterly, or concentrate on God during the week, when we come to church, we just hear this about God, 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 God. We're not accustomed to it. What do we think is boring?
Okay, just to go back a little, one of the sisters asked us what were areas of study that we had to show self-control in. So my area of study was linguistics and education, and I also did some literature as well. And sometimes there would be shows that would be, as a literature student, you know, sometimes you'd have to go to plays at the theater in Port of Spain. And sometimes it would be on a Friday night. And, you know, there I had to, you know, tell myself, okay, it's the Sabbath and I cannot go. And I had to, you know, probably find out from somebody how it was. But I had to show some self-control there as it relates to my belief and what I stand for.
All right. We'll take one more comment. And we're seeing from Brother Kiga again. And it says, finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are noble, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of good report, if there is any virtue and there is anything praiseworthy, meditate on these things. Amen. And Nikisha Alexander says, I second this young man. Truth is, we focus on the earthly man and not Christ himself. And Sister Natonia Houston, good night to you. Happy Sabbath. Another Shantimel member. So true, brother. Sister Sarana English, and when some of us come to church, we sleep like if we are in our bed. So true. That can happen sometimes. At this time, we'll break for a special item of music.
Forgiven. as one who's learned compassion. I've been so loved that I raise love into.
Welcome back to Youth Life Unplugged. We thank you for that special item of music. Now we just want to take some comments from our online viewers. Pastor Paul Roach, he says, I will have to take my leave. I'm using data, but it's good seeing and hearing from you all. Stay blessed and keep trusting God. Bye and have a wonderful Sabbath.
Happy
Pastor
Sabbath.
Roach, bye and have a wonderful Sabbath.
We have
okay, now we're going to wrap up this segment, our discussion tonight. It was a wonderful discussion tonight, I must admit. So online viewers, we want you to send in your prayer requests. You know, God is a miracle-working God. God is so good. He answers prayers. And so we're going to pray for your request tonight so you can start sending in your prayer request. We just have one more thing to discuss. What are some principles Christian youth can apply to help them exercise self-control in this area of our lives? What are some principles Christian youth can apply to help them exercise self-control in this area of our lives?
Well, one of the first things I like to say is to keep focus on God, right? Keep focus on the things which are godly and trying to abstain from the things which are worldly.
A principle I will say is to obey what God says, because he says, in everything that we do, do it to the glory of him. So if we know that the entertainment that we're having, it's not going to glorify God, or it will distance us from God, then we know that we should pull ourselves away from it.
Definitely. And I just want to extend to what they had said already, that we as people, we should really seek to spend some quality time in the Word, because transformation begins when we really spend time and quality time with Christ, and he will be able to transform our mind.
Okay, and we just want to take a comment from Colleen. It says, entertainment, when not properly supervised, can be dangerous to young minds. As a teacher, I encountered a child who looked at sexual movies while his dad was asleep. When I brought it to the father's attention, he just said to me that I'm old already, so I go to bed early and leave them to watch the TV. I don't have time to stay up with them. This was so disturbing to me. Young minds can be damaged due to things they are exposed to. As adults, we need to be extremely careful what we do in raising our children.
Well said.
That is so true.
And you know, as that was said, you know, sometimes you might see a child, a young person do something, and we see that, well, that young person bad, how they could do that, but we don't know the limits that parents take in helping them to have self-control. Sometimes parents leave children to do what they want and stuff like that. So parents, as parents, you have a job, and it's to train up your child in the way that he or she should grow, so that when they get old, they will not depart from it.
Okay, we see we have Sarana English. Okay, she would like, I would like for you to pray for my son to be successful in everything he do in his schoolwork. So right before we continue reading the prayer request, we'd like to do some promotions. It says, breaking news for a better society evangelistic series with evangelist Pastor Marlon Peters. Come and experience dynamic preaching, sensational singing, prayers for all your problems, health lectures, baby dedications, free counseling, gifts, and much more. Longwall, Grenville, St. Andrews, September 8, 2019, 7 p.m. nightly. Also, the East Central District presents The King is Coming, Gospel Explosion with Pastor Shanice Isidore, Friday 23rd, August 2019. So this crusade is ongoing, Birch Grove, and it's 7 p.m. nightly. Says the come and be blessed. We also have coming up the Bible Connection.
Well, yeah, we have the big Bible Connection final right here tomorrow at 3:30. Who would it be? I know each and every one of you are waiting for that day. You've been waiting a long time. I know all the persons who are participating have been putting in the studies. Well, tomorrow is the day. We want everybody to come right here at Snellor. Come early. The parking is limited, so you need to come here really early tomorrow. And we'll have a wonderful time right here at Snellor. It's a big Bible Boom, a Connect final right here at Snellor tomorrow. Don't miss it.
Amen. We live in a culture that tells us life is short, grab what you want right away. We don't often hear the message of patience, delayed gratification, self-denial. Yet, these are the principles not just of Christian living, but of all successful living. Learning to use self-control to put off short-term pleasure in pursuit of long-term goals. Help youth to focus on the big picture, not on rules and regulations, but on what they want to accomplish in life through God's power and what kind of self-control they'll need to achieve their goals. We thank you all for viewing tonight. We had such a, you know, that we're going to share it with someone else. We're going to spread the word. We're going to let them know that Youth Life Unplugged is on Friday night, so we can come and share God and for his continued guidance through my struggles.
Cassandra said, God is in control. He makes things easier. Self-control can be dangerous. Self seeks after desires.
We have Dwight McLeish. Pray for me to have self-control in everything I do. So before we take the prayer, we'll just like to sing this song, Sweet Hour of Prayer, Sweet Hour of Prayer.
Sweet hour of prayer, sweet hour of prayer that calls me from a world of care and bids me and my Father's throne make all my wants and wishes known in sin. Stress and grief, my soul has often found relief and oft escaped the tempter's snare by return, sweet hour of prayer.
At this moment, we just want to ask our live audience to bow your heads right where you are, and even those who are witnessing or viewing at this moment. Heavenly Father, we are truly grateful for this awesome privilege whereby we can come before you. We thank you for this awesome topic that we had, this discussion that we had here this evening. We understand through Scripture that self-control is also one of the fruit that we should exhibit as believers. And so, Lord, we want to ask at this moment that you would fill us with the Holy Spirit, because without your Holy Spirit, we cannot do nothing. And so we really ask you that you empower us so that we can depict this attribute of you, which is self-control. Lord, our online viewers had made the request known to you. We pray, O Lord, that you would supply all their needs. Some persons requested prayers for their children, for their students, for their home, for their individual life to have self-control. Lord, I really pray that you would answer their prayer requests. And so tonight we pray that you will continue to bless us as a people and help us to continue to represent you rightly in everything we do and say, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 We thank you once again for joining us here tonight. It was a pleasure. You know, remember, Youth Live Unplugged every Friday night at 7:30 p.m. We want to thank the persons, our live audience here tonight. You know, we do acknowledge and we are happy that you graced us with your presence here tonight. And enjoy the rest of your night and have a pleasant Sabbath.
Share your love and grace in all I do. Lord, I come before you with contrite heart. Humbly I surrender all that I am. I want to learn from you. Please draw me close to you.